Hello everyone, my name is Sophia Young. I am a senior data scientist at Anaconda. In this video, I will show you how to do basic time series forecasting in Python using the Prophet package from Facebook open source. Prophet models time series as a generalized additive model combining the trend function, seasonality function, holiday effects, and an narrow term in one model. I'll quickly go through the math here so that you have a general idea of how Prophet works. Based on your data and your assumptions, you could use either a logistic trend model or a linear trend model. For the logistic trend model, we believe that there is an upper limit, that is the carrying capacity CP here, which is a user-defined vector that can be fixed or changed over time. You may notice that the growth rate here is rather complicated. In a normal regular regression form, we normally have a fixed slope or a fixed growth rate. But in this case, our growth rate is defined as k plus a transpose delta, which represents the delta j change in growth rate at time sj. And the vector at just tells us when the change happens. Seasonality is modeled based on the Fourier series, which is a sum of weighted cosines and sine functions. The holiday models model the linear effect of the holidays, which is a vector of dummies with one indicating holidays and zero otherwise. Combining all the three models together, we get the final model for our time series analysis, and then based on the priors of the parameters and the data, we can find maximum a posterior estimates for all our parameters. So that's a very brief overview of how the model works. If you're interested in learning more, please refer to this paper that I linked here. There are a lot of parameters we can tune in Prophet. Here I listed all the parameters you can tune, and this webpage documented more details on tunable parameters. I will not go over this list here, but you can always refer back to this list or the Prophet documentation if you need it. Also, there are other features in Prophet that we will not cover in our example today. Something just to keep in mind when you use Prophet in the future. For example, you can add additional regressors. You can specify additional seasonalities that's not already defined. Great, so now let's jump into our example. In this example, I'm going to show you how to use Prophet to model and predict the package pandas downloads from Anaconda. First, let's set up our environment using this environment.yaml file, or you can use conda install to install needed packages in your environment. Let's import all the needed packages. Note that we will be using Dask here to run the diagnostics of the model in parallel. In Dask, you can specify the number of possibly distributed nodes, the number of processes, the number of threads within each process. In our example, we have 8 processes and 1 thread per process. Now we can get the number of Anaconda's daily pandas downloads. This step may take a minute, and I'm going to speed it up and show you the results. Here we get the data from the beginning of 2018 to the end of 2020. The counts here represents the daily package downloads from pandas from Anaconda. Okay, with this data at hand, let's first try to run a basic logistic model with all the default parameters to see what we get. First, we need to rename our data frame into DS and Y. DS is our date. Y is the daily pandas downloads. We added cap and floor values for our logistic model. Here we assume that the daily pandas downloads won't go over twice the max value and below half the minimum value that we see in the past 3 years. Those two values are totally depend on your user use case and your assumptions. Please feel free to change those based on your model and your data. Next, we instantiate a profit object and then fit the data into the profit model. We then make a data frame with dates, only extending our current date to 180 days. That's the period we're looking at for forecasting purposes. Then we use the predict method to get the predicted value for each date. We can plot our model using the plotly method, or we can just use dot plot directly. There are two ways to plot the data here. It depends on if we want to use plotly or not. Here, the black dots represents the actual data points. The blue lines are the predicted values and also the uncertainty intervals. We can also plot different components. We can see the trend, the weekly seasonality, and the yearly seasonality in this plot. Okay, now we can use cross-validation to check model performance. Cross-validation in profit uses historical data and compares the forecasted values with the real values in history. Initial defines the size of the initial training period. Period defines the cutoff dates between two or more training periods. Horizon defines how many days we're going to make a forecast on. With our values defined here, we see 7 forecasts. We use Dask to run these 7 forecasts in parallel. Here we see a performance matrix showing several different model fit statistics. We can plot each of the statistics by calling this metric. So basically, if we plot the mean absolute percent error, we can see the percent error for our prediction is around 50%, which is not very good. Now let's see if we can tune our hyperparameters to get a better model fit. First, we define the parameters we want to tune on. I'm trying a lot of different parameters here. Note that normally we don't tune whether the model is linear or logistic. It should be based on your assumptions and your data. But because the trend here we see above looks very linear, so I'm going to see if the linear trend model works better than the logistic trend model. And also just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to train those two separately. I have also added the holiday effects because people might use pandas less during holidays. Because I'm running so many combinations of hyperparameters, this step will take several hours to run. Note that I'm using Dask again to parallelize the tasks, and Dask indeed saved me a lot of time. Then we can get the best parameters based on the metrics we're interested in. Here we're looking at the mean absolute percent error for our model. Here we get the best combination of parameters. And then we can try run another model with this set of parameters and see if our model fit has improved or not. And indeed, we see that our model fit has improved. The mean absolute percent error dropped from 50% to 25%. And again, we can see the overall trend, and also we can plot each component. Here we can see a clear linear trend going up. We can see a decrease during holidays. For the yearly seasonality, you can see a dip in December, January, and maybe a dip during the summer. And then for the weekly seasonality, we see a dip on the weekends. So overall, profit is very easy to use, easy to tune. And based on this paper that I have linked before, that profit performs better than traditional time series models. Also, there is a library called NeuroProfit that uses PyTorch as the backend for the profit models. If you are interested in a neural network-based time series model, be sure to check out this project. Yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Bye.